Steve's setting the initial lash on the valves. I'm gonna test fit the intake. This thing is gonna be sweet. And it fits perfectly. But we wanna run a vacuum pump on this thing, instead of running a bead of silicone, we're gonna have to figure out some cork. Yeah. What Steve's working on right now is what's called a stud girdle. So it uses a really long poly lock, which is the thing that holds the rocker arm down. And it is a clamp that goes around each one of those poly locks to stabilize all of these rocker studs so that they're not wobbling around with the high spring pressure and big lift and potentially RPM of a solid roller can. This thing doesn't really have an RPM problem, fortunately, but this is still gonna add valve train stability since we don't have a trick like shaft mounted rocker. It's a regular old stud rocker. Just, this is the same rocker we took off that other engine on the stock heads.
Let's go right on. How big is your Dominator?
1250.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Why'd you put the small one on? I make a 1420.
I asked you, you wanted this one.
Yeah.
Well, the old one was the Freiberger combo, this is the Brulio combo.
I like the Brulio combo way better.
Probably. So
yeah.
We got the whole Brodix setup dialed. Steve Brule is now gonna tune this thing up while we go hide in the corner, and then we'll come back and find out how much power this thing makes. All right, I think you guys are about to be a lot happier with this engine.
It's a little more what I'm normally doing.
I know.
I suspect I'll like it a lot better too.
This thing's gonna be stout, watch this.
You're the odd man out, Freiberger.
I know. More stout than I expected by quite a bit. I didn't think 10 to 1 compression ratio would get us there. So essentially we just bolted on 300 horsepower.
That would be a cover blurb.
Yeah, I know. Not even essentially, we did on 300 horsepower.
Almost exact, actually a little better than three.
So this thing just made 774.9 pound-feet of torque and up top 853 horsepower at 6,300 RPM. Now, what blows my mind actually is how much more torque it made than the small combo. It just bumped it up. But look how flat it is. What's it making down here at 4,500?
About 774.
Yeah, 762. So a lot of people will look at that, I think, who are not familiar with these types of things and go, oh, well, this made more torque, so this is more the torque engine. But the whole key is the RPM range at which it happens.
Even down at 3,600, it still made 673, so that is a beast.
So that's the overlay of the iron heads versus the Brodix top end combo. These red lines down here are what we did with the tiny camshaft and stock heads. And look at that, that is what's going on. But this is a real visual that tells you that even though this is making way more torque, I think when people think of a torque motor, they're thinking of torque that is easily drivable at low RPM at part, you know, throttle
position.
Torque
at lower engine speeds, not
right.
At max output of torque.
I know you guys think I was cracked walking into this test, but what my goals were for it were first to find out what happens if you basically put 454 parts on a 598, and second to talk about the difference in a torque motor and a horsepower motor, and it backfired on me a little bit that the horsepower motor also made more torque. But what are your takeaways from this? I mean, there's more engine dynamics going on here than we've really talked about. What has it made you think about?